Meet the guardian of Mexico's fat mountains. Here's how to help the Atlantic salmon avoid extinction. Swimming with manta rays could help save them. The battle to save China's black snub-nosed monkeys. NASA technology helps save the world's largest shark. Millions of penguins protected thanks to this man. A frozen rainforest of microscopic life is melting Greenland's ice sheet. Two women are enduring their second Arctic winter to highlight climate change. How these sinks regulate the climate. Can polar bears survive the climate crisis? In Monterey Bay, scientists are tagging and tracking white sharks. The underwater farm on an Irish island. These students are taking our future into their own hands. Protecting South Africa's sardine run. João Campos Silva is on a mission to save a river giant. How fake birds helped restore Maine's puffin colonies. The world's toughest corals could help save dying reefs. The creature that can munch through plastic waste. The environmentalist cleaning up India's lakes. The all-female crew sailing the world to study plastic pollution. Take the plunge into one of the last wildernesses on Earth. Trackers are helping to conserve the Kalahari. How old cell phones are spying on illegal loggers. How to make food from thin air. How to save the planet. 5 simple things you can do. Protecting Sri Lanka's precious mangroves. Ecologist working to save the Sri Lankan leopard. How New Zealand's rare kakapo is making a comeback. Startup has new technology to help fix plastic crisis. Meet the man who swam through the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Why Ted Turner is bringing back bison. Ted Turner's mission to save everything. Conserving nature on a New Mexico ranch. How Captain Planet inspired eco-awareness. This team is building the world's biggest library of trees. Full of biodiversity, deserts also deserve protection. Samara Private Game Reserve. How one family's rewilding project returned big cats to the Great Karoo. The astronaut caring for spaceship Earth. Icelandic company is turning CO2 into stone. An energy plant so clean, you can ski there. Why scientists are breeding some of the ocean's top predators. Slow and steady wins the race. Restoring Bangladesh's endangered turtle and tortoise species. See how whiskey brought these oysters back to life. Young people are protecting the planet on Call to Earth Day. James Cameron wants to preserve the ocean twilight zone. Meet Hong Kong's ghost net hunter. An Indian entrepreneur has a portable solution for fighting air pollution. This startup makes packaging from seaweed. Potato custodians are safeguarding this crop's future. Fonio, the superfood that's a kernel of hope for the Sahel. Breadfruit, a new chapter for Hawaii's tree of life. 5 ways to help the planet by changing your diet. Cold hubs are keeping food fresh in Nigeria. This chef has a recipe for greener eating. Meet Matilda Ho, the food disruptor changing tastes in China. The islanders saving bees for a sustainable future. Invasive lionfish are bad for local sea life, but good for eating. The science helping New Yorkers and whales live in harmony. Scientists crusade to protect seahorses. Sebastião Salgado's Amazonian Odyssey. The Cape Cormorant rescue mission on Robben Island. UK startup uses drones to map plastic pollution. One woman's mission to help solve India's deadly conflict between people and wildlife. One month's mission to make treasure out of trash. The bubble barrier keeping plastic from the sea. Kirsten Forsberg is fighting for manta rays. How blockchain is protecting species and consumers from fish fraud. How to be good to the planet when you die. Blue Nature Alliance aims to protect 5% of the world's ocean in 5 years. Meet the forest engineer who wants to restore Brazil's lost Atlantic forest. Meet the guardian of Mexico's fat mountains. Here's how to help the Atlantic salmon avoid extinction. Swimming with manta rays could help save them. The battle to save China's black snub-nosed monkeys. NASA technology helps save the world's largest shark. Millions of penguins protected thanks to this man. A frozen rainforest of microscopic life is melting Greenland's ice sheet. Two women are enduring their second Arctic winter to highlight climate change. How these sinks regulate the climate. Can polar bears survive the climate crisis? In Monterey Bay, scientists are tagging and tracking white sharks. The underwater farm on an Irish island. These students are taking our future into their own hands. Protecting South Africa's sardine run. João Campos Silva is on a mission to save a river giant. How fake birds helped restore Maine's puffin colonies. The world's toughest corals could help save dying reefs. The creature that can munch through plastic waste. The environmentalist cleaning up India's lakes. The all-female crew sailing the world to study plastic pollution. Take the plunge into one of the last wildernesses on Earth. Trackers are helping to conserve the Kalahari. How old cell phones are spying on illegal loggers. How to make food from thin air. How to save the planet. 5 simple things you can do. Protecting Sri Lanka's precious mangroves. Ecologist working to save the Sri Lankan leopard. How New Zealand's rare kakapo is making a comeback. Startup has new technology to help fix plastic crisis. Meet the man who swam through the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Why Ted Turner is bringing back bison. Ted Turner's mission to save everything. Conserving nature on a New Mexico ranch. How Captain Planet inspired eco-awareness. This team is building the world's biggest library of trees. Full of biodiversity, deserts also deserve protection. Samara Private Game Reserve. How one family's rewilding project returned big cats to the Great Karoo. The astronaut caring for spaceship Earth. Icelandic company is turning CO2 into stone. An energy plant so clean, you can ski there. Why scientists are breeding some of the ocean's top predators. Slow and steady wins the race, restoring Bangladesh's endangered turtle and tortoise species. See how whiskey brought these oysters back to life. Young people are protecting the planet on Call to Earth Day. James Cameron wants to preserve the ocean twilight zone. Meet Hong Kong's ghost net hunter. An Indian entrepreneur has a portable solution for fighting air pollution. This startup makes packaging from seaweed. Potato custodians are safeguarding this crop's future. Fonio, the superfood that's a kernel of hope for the Sahel. Breadfruit, a new chapter for Hawaii's Tree of Life. 5 ways to help the planet by changing your diet. Cold hubs are keeping food fresh in Nigeria. This chef has a recipe for greener eating. Meet Matilda Ho, the food disruptor changing tastes in China. The islanders saving bees for a sustainable future. Invasive lionfish are bad for local sea life, but good for eating. The science helping New Yorkers and whales live in harmony. Scientists crusade to protect seahorses. Sebastião Salgado's Amazonian Odyssey. The Cape Cormorant rescue mission on Robben Island. UK startup uses drones to map plastic pollution. One woman's mission to help solve India's deadly conflict between people and wildlife. One month's mission to make treasure out of trash. The bubble barrier keeping plastic from the sea. Kirsten Forsberg is fighting for manta rays. How blockchain is protecting species and consumers from fish fraud. How to be good to the planet when you die. Blue Nature Alliance aims to protect 5% of the world's ocean in 5 years. Meet the forest engineer who wants to restore Brazil's lost Atlantic forest. CNN, an arid region of open forests and grasslands spanning 3 countries and more than 250,000 square miles, this is Gran Chaco. It's the second largest forest in South America after the Amazon, but has long been neglected, suffering from deforestation, agricultural expansion and the effects of climate change. When Bolivian conservation biologist Erika Cuéllar first saw the vast expanse in 1997, she was overcome by an urge to restore it. I am very attracted to arid lands. When I was young, I was angry that nobody cared about dry lands and everybody cared about tropical rainforest, she says. Despite looking open and empty, the area is teeming with unique vegetation and wildlife, from jaguars and ocelots to piranhas and vipers. It's also home to 9 million people, including several indigenous communities. Cuéllar took an original approach to restoration, enlisting local people and giving them technical training to become parabiologists, like paramedics, she says, but for nature. Her efforts have helped to create sustainable conservation in the region, outlawing the hunting of guanacos, an animal closely related to the llama and native to South America, and bringing the species back from the brink of extinction. Erika Cuéllar has worked tirelessly to restore and preserve the Gran Chaco region of Bolivia, as well as its wildlife, like the guanaco, pictured. For Cuéllar, land restoration is an impossible task without the involvement and knowledge of local people, Her successful parabiologist model in Gran Chaco has inspired similar programs around the world. Today, she works as an assistant professor at Sultan Qaboos University in Oman, lecturing on biodiversity and read. Nature is not a commodity. Can the world learn from indigenous people's food systems before they are lost? Through Call to Earth, CNN is reporting on the environmental challenges facing our planet and understanding the solutions. Cuéllar will be guest editor as the series explores themes around land restoration and rewilding, lending her expertise and commissioning features on the subject. CNN spoke to Cuéllar about her passion not just for conservation and natural species, but for people. The following interview has been edited for length and clarity. CNN, your conservation work has been centered on the Bolivian region of Gran Chaco. What drew you to this area? Erika Cuéllar. If you arrive for the first time in Gran Chaco, your first impression is that this is very dry and very empty. But what is incredible is all the hidden diversity, because after the first night sleeping there, you wake up and get out from your tent and you are surrounded by the footprints of many different species. It's also the first example of a national park co-administered by indigenous people, which was very interesting and novel in South America. Very rapidly I understood the importance of working with local people because they have the knowledge. It was a learning process for me, but now my approach is always related to people, even if the long-term objective is conservation. CNN. Why is it important to involve indigenous people in land restoration, and how did you do this? Erika Cuéllar. Indigenous people have the knowledge, they have the connection and, at least in Bolivia, they use the natural resources for living, hunting or fishing, for instance. So, you are dealing with an ecosystem that involves people, and this is sometimes missing in conservation projects. If we want to protect a place and we have a lot of people nearby, we don't need to bring people from outside. Erika Cuéllar with parabiologists Alejandro Arambizond and Joaquin Barrientos. CNN. It's been almost a decade since you left Gran Chaco to work in other areas. What do you believe your legacy is? Erika Cuéllar. The greatest achievement is that I see those people that were in my training program working as professionals now. They are working as guardians or park rangers and they are also advisors to their community. I am so proud to see that. For example, last year two of the parabiologists I trained were involved in the creation of protected areas. Others have represented their people in front of the municipality and in front of the government. They don't depend on me, and that is my achievement. They can articulate the problems, they can suggest solutions, and they can discuss others' potential solutions they do or do not agree with. CNN. You've been credited with saving the guanaco in the Gran Chaco region, helping to push through a ban on hunting, suggesting a breeding program, and coming up with a recovery plan for the species' grassland habitat. Why is it important to save them? Erika Cuéllar. The guanaco is one of the two South American camels, except they don't have a hump. They are wild species and historically the guanaco was widely distributed in Bolivia from the highlands to the lowlands, but today the only known population that exists in the country is the Chacoan, from Gran Chaco, populations. It was important to me to catch the attention of the international scientific community, because the guanaco is considered a least concerned species as it is everywhere in Argentina, but in Bolivia, it was going to extinction. Read. Whole forests will be saved. Is solar cooking more than just a flash in the pan? With public awareness and almost 10 years of monitoring the population of guanacos and just fighting for it, working there, we saved the species from extinction. For me, that is a great happiness in my life. CNN. What are the critical issues facing the planet right now, and how can land restoration help to protect it? Erika Cuéllar. There are many critical issues. Of course, one of the most obvious is the accelerated rate of climate change. Another great problem now is the massive migration of people, which will affect natural areas. I think we are very worried about the extinction of species and maybe we're not thinking enough about the extinction of knowledge. The knowledge of people who are really connected and understand the patterns inside ecosystems have been neglected and they are very important. Conservation without people is just gardening. I always use the phrase. We are part of the system. I think we need more hands and more brains and more help if we really want to hurry and protect these areas. We need allies where the land we want to conserve is. The empowerment of local people is important.